Hi everyone, my name is Shomadrita Pal. I had completed my BSc Agriculture. Now I am pursuing MSc last semester. Last 4 years I am teaching all GRF related exams and all agriculture related exams. And also teaching 5 to 10 class students for science groups and English also. Today I am going to teach you the two subjects. One is chemistry and other is biology. Well, the chemistry topic is suspension, solution and colloidal, and biological topic is photosynthesis. Now come to the topic solution, suspension and colloidal. What is solution? A homogeneous mixture of two or more substances is known as solution. Homogeneous solution is also known as true solution. A true solution is defined as the solution containing solute particle of a diameter equals to or less than 10 to the power 8 cm distributed uniformly throughout the entire mass of the solvent. The characteristic of a solution, sir. A solution is a homogeneous, that is the composition and properties of any part of the solution, however small, remain the same. The relative proportion of the components of a solution may be altered. 2. Both the solvent and solute pass together through the pores of a filter paper. 4. In solution, the solute exists in molecular dimensions as molecules, atoms and ions. Relation between saturated, unsaturated and supersaturated solution at a particular temperature. The solution which can dissolve more solute with the increase of its density is called unsaturated solution. The solution which cannot dissolve more solute and hold density does not alter in spite of adding solute to it is called saturated solution, and the solution which may be forced to dissolve excess of solute by changing the environment is called supersaturated solution. The density of such solution is decreased on addition of a piece of solute. Aqueous solution and non-aqueous solution. Aqueous solution, the solution made by dissolving various solutes in water is called aqueous solution. Non-aqueous solution, the solution made by dissolving in solution is liquid other than in water, including organic liquids are called non-aqueous solution. The organic liquid like alcohol, aqueous acetone, carbon disulfide and benzene, etc. are called non-aqueous solution.
Solute plus solvent equal to solution. Binary tertiary solution. A solution prepared by mixing two substances, example sugar in water, is known as binary solution. A solution is prepared by mixing three substances is known as tertiary solution. Example, the homogeneous mixture of solution. Substance can exist in three different physical states depending on the state of the solute and that of the solvent. 9 different type of solutions are possible as given in the table. Physical state of solution, type of solution, their example. Physical state of solution are classified gaseous solution, liquid solution, solid solution. And gaseous solutions types, solution of a gas in gas, solution of a liquid in gas, and solution of a solid in gas. Their examples are air, small water droplets in air, aerosol and smoke. And liquid solution. Liquid solutions type, solution of gas in liquid, solution of liquid in liquid, and solution of solid in liquid. Their examples are air, dissolved water and arrested water, etc. Solution of H2SO4 in water, alcohol in water, etc. and sugar in water, salt in water, etc. And solid solution. Solid solutions types are solution of gas in solute, solid, solution of liquid in solid, and solution of solid in solid. Their examples are solution of hydrogen gas in palladium, sodium amalgam, sodium in mercury, and steel carbon in iron. Then unsaturated, saturated and supersaturated solution depending upon concentration. Solution is divided into three class.
Now what is suspension? Suspension, fine particle of insoluble substance like sand, chalk, etc. When added to water and the mixture is stirred, it becomes turbid as the fine particles move about freely in water. If this turbid mixture is left for down due to the gravitational force, but the more fine particle remains suspended in water, in suspension, the diameter of fine particle is more than 10 to the power 5 centimeter. This mixture of this fine particle in water is for long period of time. The particles are large enough to be seen by eye with or without the aid of microscope. The particles of suspension do not pass through filter paper. They can scatter light. The suspension is a heterogeneous mixture in which the small visible particle of a solid are spread throughout a liquid without dissolving it. Example, chalk water mixture, muddy water, paints, milk of magnesium and sand particles suspended in water, floor water mixture, etc. A suspension of a barium sulfate in water is an opaque mixture for X-ray. So it is used for diagnostic X-ray, commonly called barium X-ray. Characteristic of suspension. Importance of characteristic suspension, sir. The size of solid particle in a suspension of larger than 10 to the power 5 cm in diameter. Particle of suspension can be seen easily. The particle of a suspension do not pass through a filter paper, so a suspension can be separated by filtration. The suspensions are unstable. The particle of a suspension and settle down after a same time. A suspension scatter a beam of light passing through it. The Tyndall effect can be shown in a suspension.
What is colloid? In between the suspension and true solution, there is a separate state in which the diameter of the particle range from 10 to the power 5 cm to 10 to the power 7 cm. The colloid particles are too small to be seen by ordinary microscope. They can only be observed by high power ultramicroscope. So colloids are not true solution. Thus, a mixture of a barley or glue in water never settle down, but from heterogeneous stable suspension, these particles are colloid. Definition: a heterogeneous system where particle of diameter 10 to the power 5 cm to 10 to the power 7 cm of an insoluble substance are kept in a suspension in solvent where they move freely. Do not from a clear solution but from a translucent heterogeneous. Characteristic of colloids. The important characteristic of colloids are: a colloid appears to be homogeneous but actually it is heterogeneous. The size of particle in a colloid is bigger than those in a true solution but smaller than those of suspension. It is between 10 to the power 7 cm and 10 to the power 5 cm in diameter. The particle of a colloid can pass through a filter paper, so a colloid cannot be separated by filtration. And the colloids are quite stable. The particle of a colloid do not separate out on keeping. A colloid scatter a beam of light passing through it, and brownish movement and Tyndall effect can be observed in a colloid. What is Brownian movement? Colloidal particle, when examined under powerful ultramicroscope, appear to be in state of constant rapid zigzag motion in all directions. This was first observed by Robert Brown, and this motion is known as Brownian movement. This is due to the bombardment of the particle of dispersion medium on the colloidal particle. As a result, at equilibrium, the colloidal particle acquired a kinetic energy which is equal to that of the kinetic energy of the particle of dispersing medium. The acquired kinetic energy of the colloidal particle is exhibited in their Brownian movement, and the colloidal particle move with a speed slower than
and the particle of the dispersing medium due to their heavier mass. The smaller size of the colloidal particle, rapid is the movement. What is Tyndall effect? Tyndall effect is an optical property of colloids. Tyndall effect can be used to distinguish between a colloidal from a true solution. Definition: visible scattering of light along the path of a beam of light as it passes through colloid is called Tyndall effect. The luminous path of the beam of light is called Tyndall concentration. Difference between suspension colloids and true solution. Suspension: diameter of the particle is equals to or more than 10 to the power 5 centimeter is called suspension, and colloidal, the diameter of a particle is in between 10 to the power 5 centimeter to 10 to the power 7 centimeter, and true solutions, diameter of the particle is less than 10 to the power 8 centimeter. So in case of suspension, particle are visible by naked eye or by microscope, and in case of colloidal, particles are not visible naked eyes or by microscope but can be observed by ultramicroscope. And in case of true solution, not visible even by ultramicroscope. And in case of suspension, heterogeneous true phase system. In case of colloidal, heterogeneous two phase system. And in case of true solution, homogeneous one phase system. In case of suspension, precipitations under the force of gravity. In case of colloidal, coagulated by the addition of electrolytes, and in case of true solution cannot be coagulated. In case of suspension, color depend on the particle. In case of colloidal, colors depend on the size of the colloidal particle, and in case of true solution, color depend on the soluble salt or iron. In case of suspension, light cannot pass Tyndall effect, ordinarily does not occur. In case of colloidal, exhibit Tyndall effect, and in case of true solution does not exhibit a Tyndall effect. In case of suspension, cannot passes through filter paper or parchment paper. In case of colloidal, may passes through filter paper but cannot passes through parchment paper, and in case of true solution can easily passes through filter paper or parchment paper.
Now I am going to teach you my second subject topic, which is photosynthesis. So photosynthesis is what? All the living organisms need energy to perform their different normal metabolic function. Food is the source of energy of the living body. During the oxidation process, respiration, that potential or stored energy is converted to kinetic energy, whereby necessary energy is supplied to the living body. The green chlorophyllous organism produce food by means of a special physiological function. During this process, the solar energy is stored within the food as a potential energy. This special physiological function is called photosynthesis. The process is one of the remarkable activities of a living cell of green plant. And Julius Robert Mayer, in the year 1845, this scientist first to recognize that green plant have the power to utilize the light energy and afterward convert into chemical energy of organic matter with the evolution of oxygen. In 1862, Such and others state that starch is a photosynthetic product. The term photosynthesis was derived from photo means light and synthesis means building up. The green cell synthesize enormous amount of food material with the help of light energy, preferably available from the sun. The synthesis of food is called photosynthesis.